Namaste, good evening, welcome to another episode. Today we'll talk about a very important topic, and which is inflammation. Okay. In today's world, inflammation is mandatory. Everybody has some sort of inflammation. Some have got chronic inflammation, some do not have, but we all have inflammation. Now this inflammation can be because of any ongoing medical ailment, it can be because of any physical stress, it can be because of psychological stress, or for any other reason. So why does inflammation happen, and why inflammation is not really a bad thing, and in case there is inflammation, what can we do to fix it? Okay, that's what we'll try and answer today. Now, inflammation is our body's ability to fight any attack, as simple as that. So let's say there is an attack on your body through an injury mark, through a pathogen, bacteria or viral. The immune system rushes towards that affected part. That part gets inflamed. It repairs, heals, and the part comes back to normal. Now, when this does not happen, when this happens, but the inflammation does not come down, that becomes chronic inflammation. Now, if we do not have inflammation, we will not be able to fight any attack that the body goes through. So it is very, very important for us to have an optimal level of inflammation. So inflammation is basically, if you look at, it's our body's natural mechanism to take care of an issue. Now what happens is, our body is supposed to have inflammation in response to a threat, and this should come down. But when we are in constant state of stress, okay, we are always under a threat, we are always under a pressure, and the inflammation stays up, it does not come down, then that becomes chronic, and anything which is chronic is bad for us. So that's what the whole story of inflammation is. How do we manage it? That's another question. So let's understand why inflammation, what is inflammation, how does it happen? Now whatever activity we do in our body, okay, whether I'm talking, I'm walking, sleeping, eating, my body is repairing itself in the night, there is the body is using the energy, and that energy is releasing a byproduct, that is a free radical, that when it is oxidized becomes oxidative stress, and this stress leads to inflammation. So no matter what we do, there would be some byproduct which is, if it's not eliminated through our excretion process, through our mental de-stress, physical de-stress, will lead to inflammation. Okay. Now, ideally our body should have, to manage inflammation, you need a lot of omega-3. Omega-3 you get from fish, you can get from nuts and seeds, you get from walnut, you get from olive oil, and a ratio of omega-3 to omega-6 should be up to 3 parts of omega-6 and 1 part of omega-3, so that the body's ability to have inflammation, pro-inflammation and anti-inflammation runs simultaneously. Unfortunately, due to our current lifestyle, because of what we eat, the way we sleep, the way we manage our stress, the way we are, our brain is functioning over time, there's too much that we're trying to do, this ratio has become somewhere around 30 parts of pro-inflammation and 1 part of anti-inflammation. So if inflammation is there, there has to be an equal amount of anti-inflammation. So do we need to take anti-inflammatories? No. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatories, NSAIDs, which people are being prescribed left, right and center to manage inflammation, are causing more problems. You don't have to look at that. You have to look at your own kitchen. You have an answer to it. So if you look at our age-old science, they prescribe that there are four important things that we can do to manage. One is use of dairy. Okay. So if you know a good source of dairy, which is does not have antibiotics, it does not have estrogen, does not have hormones, dairy is very good for managing inflammation. Honey, the second. Third is ghee, and fourth is turmeric. So we'll talk about turmeric today. Now turmeric has got a compound known as curcumin. Okay? So 100 grams of turmeric will have somewhere around 2 grams of curcumin. out of which our ability to absorb is somewhere around 4 to 6%. Now, curcumin is a lipophilic, means it does not get absorbed or dissolved in water. It needs a source of fat, and that was the reason when we are cooking a traditional food, when we add any fat and we put turmeric, that's when it becomes more bioavailable and it gets better absorbed in the body. Turmeric, the curcumin in it, is not easily absorbed. So it gets conjugated in our liver fast and it gets excreted out of our liver. In order for turmeric to be bioavailable, so that when I say bioavailable means whatever I'm taking, my ability to absorb that or utilize that. If you want to increase that, just add some crushed peppercorns in whenever you use turmeric. Now, how can we include turmeric? So our traditional Indian cuisine has got turmeric being used in pickles, in gravies, in vegetables. Okay, people make sabji out of fresh turmeric. But since we are eating out, I think the consumption has gone down. But can we stop eating out? I don't think so. But what can we do if you have to get turmeric in a diet? So one good recipe that you guys, everybody can do, and I'll give you the recipe right now, which will help in a lot of ways. So you take equal portions of coriander seeds, which is dhania, equal portion of cumin, jeera, and fennel, which is sauf. Okay, mix equal portions. So whether it is your measure is 1 cup, 1 gram, 1 tablespoon, 1 kg, that's up to you. Add, mix this, take 1 spoon per cup of this mixture, add with 1/4 teaspoon to up to half a teaspoon per cup of turmeric, crushed peppercorns, little bit of cinnamon, and crushed ginger, fresh ginger or ginger powder. Boil this in a cup of water for 10 minutes, strain, and add some lemon juice to it and raw honey to it. Now, this potent combination, anybody from a 2-year-old to an 80-year-old can take it. You can take it somewhere around 2 to 3 cups of it. This will help you to fight seasonal fever. This will repair your body. This will be anti-inflammatory. It will be antimicrobial. It will be anti-oxidative. Okay. It will increase your immunity. This will also help prevent any changes in the season that happens. It definitely increases your metabolism. It increases your stomach acid. And we know that how important is stomach acid. Okay. So this is a very simple recipe. Everybody can make it. Okay. You make a blend of it. Keep it. It is shelf stable. It can stay there for very, very long time. Include this in your diet. Okay. You can start your day with this water or tea. One during the day and one in the evening. This will definitely help you. This will help to bring your oxidative stress down. And if your oxidative stress is down, your inflammation will be down. If your inflammation goes down, your gut health will improve. And we all know that when inflammation is down and gut is improved, health and vitality definitely improves. So till next time, keep it simple, keep it sustainable. You don't have to look outside to get this fancy medicine. I think our kitchen are well equipped with everything that we want. All we need to do is have knowledge, have awareness. So do share it with others so that they can benefit, and have a wonderful, wonderful day. We'll see soon. Till then, have a wonderful evening. Namaste.